Outlander fans, the Droughtlander is finally over, and we are back. I'm here with Amanda Spears to recap every episode of the third season of Outlander, and we've just seen episode 301, The Battle Joined. Amanda, welcome back.
Yeah, thank you.
How exciting is it that we're back to talking about, you know, the best show on TV?
It's great, and the hard part is that we're such brats because we get to see it early, so we have to like exercise restraint.
We have to be very restrained, or Star will get very angry with us. So look, let's just quickly recap what the episode is about. I'm going to read the very kind of boring statement that Starz releases for each episode. And this one, The Battle Joined, written by Ronald D. Moore, the showrunner and creator, and directed by Brendan Mayer. And this one is about, after living through the Battle of Culloden, Jamie finds himself at the mercy of unforgiving British victors until a connection from his past provides his only hope of survival. Meanwhile, a pregnant Claire attempts to adjust to life in the modern world of 1940s Boston and life with Frank. So the episode was a good one. It was really great to see all of our favorite characters back. What was your initial or your number one take from this episode, Amanda?
Well, Blackjack is dead. So I wanted a more satisfying ending to such a character that we learned to love to hate, So I don't know. It was a little overwrought. And it just wasn't enough. I wanted to see them like really battle each other out and then the sword go through the gut. And we didn't really get that kind of a scene.
Yeah, I wonder why, because Outlander, as wonderful as it is, it does sometimes go to that melodrama place, and not in a bad way, but it really does play up a lot of very emotional and emotionally satisfying scenes. And for this, it didn't necessarily do that, and we love to hate Blackjack, and he's gone. That's it. We're just all moving on.
For the main antagonist, that's the right word for the past couple of seasons. I just wanted a little bit more. I mean, we got more of a death out of the Duke of Sandringham than we did out of Blackjack. I mean, he really got his head cut off right in front of us.
Yeah, he did. Oh my God, I'm still recovering from that.
His sword was not as sharp as the ones they use on Game of Thrones when they cut off heads.
Definitely not. They really should probably go to the same Costco. But anyway, but what about generally about the episode? Were you as enraptured with it as you were last season? Were you happy to see it back? Like, what was the main reaction?
I really thought Tobias Menzies really, really got to stand out this episode.
Yeah.
And especially Claire too. I don't know how she traveled back to the future and came back even more modern with this whole, like, I have to be pretty for my boss's husband, the husband's boss. And yeah. I found their dynamic the more interesting, just because I don't really care that much about the people that Jamie knows. Whereas you kind of feel bad for Frank, and Katrina warned us to feel bad. We were going to feel bad for Frank.
Yeah, I think so too. Like, you know, I've got to say this. We've said it before, but Tobias Menzies is such a good actor. Like, you know, we're in the scenes where, you know, we open on the Battle of Culloden and Jamie's lying in the old dead ashes of the aftermath as he relives it in flashbacks. And then we see that Blackjack's dead body is laying on top of him. It's a really good way to open the show. And then as we see how he died, he falls onto Jamie and dies, which is kind of then harks back to, you know, other scenes from season one, how they did have that physical connection, good or bad. So we had all of that to watch. And then we have Frank. Things are not going well, you know. They're not happy as a couple. Claire is there and kind of she's just going with the flow because that's where she needs to be and she can't be where she really wants to be. It's a really bittersweet beginning to the season, and I think Tobias Menzies just kills it. He's such a wonderful, wonderful actor, and I don't know if he gets enough credit. What do you think?
Yeah, you know, the more I thought about it, the more I was like, God, you know, it was such a shame that he just didn't submit himself for guest star for Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
6, because with that and with Outlander and playing what I think is the scariest character, the gynecologist on Catastrophe.
I know, that's even better.
I wouldn't let him near me.
Yeah.
But horrible. I think he would have definitely snuck in. I really honestly think with all of it, he would have made that, he would have cracked that top 6.
Yeah, he's a known actor, and he even got a Golden Globe nomination, which is something, because the Hollywood Foreign Press generally only goes for people with names that they recognize. So yeah, that's a shame. But we'll see how he goes in this season. You know, we don't know what's happening going forward. So we'll see how Tobias Menzies continues that journey for Frank. And we might see flashbacks with Blackjack. Who knows? As everybody watching this must already know by now, we have not read the books. We are just talking about the show, and we talk about it week to week. I have no clue what's happening later on. And I think that's quite refreshing. Like, so you're going to get a view from two people who have no clue what's happening later. And we're just kind of giving you our reactions from as we watch the show that we have grown to love so much. So anyway,
that's just for the viewers, we do a fan favorite gallery. So if you put a comment about what you love about the episode in the below in the comments, you might see it later in our fan favorite gallery.
Exactly. So make sure you guys are getting, we want more interactivity with our Outlander fans, because there's so many of you out there. This show is so beloved by its fans. I've never seen anything like it. Game of Thrones doesn't hold a candle to the way Outlander fans just rabidly and lovingly and loyally support this show. So that's really cool. And we want to make sure that we can get you guys involved as much as possible. So yes, please do comment.
I did love that Jamie was calling for Murtaugh. I'm like, I want to see Murtaugh.
Oh, that broke my heart. It really did. And of all people, you and I especially love that, because as we all know, everybody loves Murtaugh. Yes. Hashtag everybody loves Murtaugh. So what else? So let's think about other things that happened. So Jamie's pardoned and saved himself from certain death, and he's back in Lallybroch. That's interesting. So he's going back to that life. So we see Jamie kind of going through his life, starting it fresh, I suppose, in this new world order that is now the case in Scotland. I liked that. It's, you know, for once he's not, you know, having a knife to his neck. Like, you know, he was under a lot of threat in season 2, and I think now, from what I can see, he's going to start his journey away from Claire and as a new man. What do you think about that?
Yeah, he doesn't seem like he's ready to let go, though. He seems like he's still kind of, he doesn't have anyone to go to. Like, he knows he sent her back to Frank, but he's just kind of left alone. So we're going to see what he gets up to.
Yeah.
And he's still pretty handsome, so the ladies are still going to be like throwing themselves at him.
They'll be throwing themselves at him. They'll be verklempt everywhere he goes. I totally agree. I noticed as well that he... there are galleries for every single scenario in this show. I noticed as well he left the dragonfly in amber behind on the battlefield as well. I noticed that little touch, and obviously that's from the books. That was a really nice touch for me, because it just gave me connectivity to the finale of season 2, and I liked to see how the different time periods connect or relate to each other in certain ways, and because that's very interesting to me.
Their cinematography on this show is so beautiful. They got a Guild nomination for cinematography.
Yeah.
They probably would have got a costume nomination if it wasn't for the fact that Westworld took up 2 spots.
Yes, that's right.
So I think they're doing pretty well. They can keep this up.
You know, we've talked about this before, but if this show was on a different network, I think it would already be a huge Emmy and other award show player, because there just seems to be some kind of issue between Emmy voters and Stars, because we don't have that issue at the Golden Globes. It's done very well there.
They couldn't get Cloris Leachman nominated. I mean, let's think about that. They could not get...
Yeah, that's right.
Cloris Leachman.
For American Gods. And... Gods underperformed, Outlander underperformed. It doesn't do... Black Sails gets a couple of tech nominations. Blunt Talk with Patrick Stewart and Jackie Weaver couldn't get a thing. So
if that was on Showtime, it would have probably been nominated for series and actor.
100%. And I think if Outlander was on HBO, for example, it would just be killing it.
Well, George R.R. Martin agrees with
Yeah. I think that stinks, but you know, we can't, I guess we're just gonna have to move on, but it is something that we have talked about before, and I'm hoping this coming Emmy season that maybe something gives and they give something back to this show, because it really deserves it. And that's coming from someone like me who never intended to really get into this show. I was always a little bit kind of resistant to it. I thought it was more of a women's show and I wouldn't get it and I wouldn't care about it, but it's just absolutely not the case. It's very well done and beautifully written and directed and shot and acted, and I'm hoping it gets some more attention.
Yeah, definitely.
So the only other thing I can think about from this episode that's aired is that, so we see Brianna being born, and that's the beginning of her journey. She her real father is obviously hundreds of years away. So Frank has to take on that responsibility, and you can see that he is the kind of person who would really take that on happily, even though there is this domestic unrest between him and Claire. So there's that as well.
Yeah, he really loves that baby. You can tell just from like the first, we didn't get a lot of it, but it's like, oh.
Yeah, absolutely. So look, before we sign off, tell me, Amanda, what is it about this show? Like overall, what do you love about it now that it's back and it's in our lives again? When someone asks you, why do you love Outlander? What do you say?
I say that I love the idea that they did a time traveling story. And they didn't set it in like modern time. They set it in two different time periods. So even though they're very different, there are still some similarities as far as the way they treated women and the way women were viewed between the 40s and the 1800s, where nowadays it would probably be a lot more of a culture shock. So yeah. I do love that aspect of it. And I love Claire and Murtaugh.
Yeah, and Jamie, and you know, and Frank, and I really love how I think Sam Heughan and Katrina Balfe. Mm-hmm. I'm just talking about the series now. Like, I know what you're saying is 100% right. It's a really good reason for why we love the show and the books and the whole package. But as for the show, I just think they've cast it so wonderfully. Like Sam and Katrina have such a great chemistry, and I hate that word because a lot of interviewers and media talk about chemistry when they have nothing else to talk about. And so when they're asking questions to people and you hear them say, what's the chemistry like between, you know, they have nothing else and so they're just bored. So look out for that. But I believe that the chemistry is actually really great between them. They're obviously very fond of each other in real life. They're great friends. They're both, you know,
if you follow them on Twitter, you know, because they love to poke fun at each other.
Good mates, which is fantastic. And the fans lap that up as they should. But they're both gorgeous to look at, you know. They're both obviously, they seem really nice people, and their acting just is off the charts. They really, really, really sell these two characters and how much they love each other. And I just think that's really cool. I don't get to see that kind of connection very often on a television series. And so I think it's it gets to a point where I'm like, I really appreciate that. So anyway.
It was perfectly cast. The actress playing Brianna in the later episodes, we only met her in the season finale, but
yeah,
that's a hard thing to cast, to find a redhead who's got the smarts of Claire but the looks of Jamie in it.
Yeah, incredible. Ooh. I did a good job.
Even the actor who played Black Jack's brother last season, he looked a little bit like Tobias Menzies. I mean, they definitely know how to cast.
I must go up onto IMDb and remember who the casting directors are so that we can name them next episode. But anyway, I think we're good for that episode. Thank you for joining me. And everybody, please keep on all of our Outlander coverage, because it's Outlander 24/7 here at Gold Derby, as it should be.
Tom will be joining us eventually.
He will be. He's at the Toronto Film Festival. But as soon as we're able to get Outlander's number one fan, now Commander-in-Chief, on this chat, we will do so.
Curse that grammatically correct in text from the season finale.
Exactly. there's no one in the same league as Tom O'Neill. All right, everyone. Thank you very much. We'll see you next week.